तुंडम हाताय सूर्य कोटि सौरो निर्विघ्नं कुरुमे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संप्रक्तो वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरो हीनाक्षर समाम्नाय अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं रुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मिन्नित्यं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुमन्तादिर्धातुर्ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभेदां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विसृजतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां दत्त्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां पुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय नमः सिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। The next Visarga Sandhi Sutra is Rosupi, and the Anuvritti of Ahan Shabda is there, applicable only to Ahan Shabda here. So Raha, Repha is the Adesha for what? Ahan and Ahan Nakara, because the Adesha generally applies, anything, any Vidhi applies to the last letter, so Vidhi Sutra. And what should be following Ahan? For Ahan means day. So for this Ahan Shabda, the following should not be a sup. It should not be a sup. So na sup asup, tasmin supi, tasmin asupi. Tasmin asupi pare, meaning when sup is not following, then Ahan Nakara will take Repha Adesha. So annaha Repha Adesha natu supi. When sup follows, then this Repha Adesha will not be there. So the example here is Ahar Ahaha. So day by day. So if you look at Ahan plus Su, Ahan plus Su. There's a Vipsa of Ahan. Not actually a Vipsa in when you write the Pada, but here is a Samasa. It's given as a Samasa. So Ahan in first case followed by Ahan, so day by day, that is the samasa there. So what will happen here? Here nakara, both the nakaras of, meaning nakaras of both the Ahan shabdas will be replaced by Repha. So you will get Ahar, Ahar, and then the Repha at the end of the pada will become Visarga, Kharavasayana Visarjaniya. So you will get Ahar Ahaha. Then similarly, this should be Ahar Ganaha. There is a typo there, Ahar Ganaha. So group of days, Gana of Ahar. So Annam Ganaha, Ahar Ganaha. There Ahan plus Am, Shashti Bhuvachana Pratyaya is added, and Gana plus Su, Prathama Ekvachana. You get Ahan Ganaha, and the Nakara will become Repha by Rosupi. So you will get Ahar Ganaha. The next sutra is in the Tripadi, it's a Vidhi sutra, Rori and Lopaha. The Lopa is the Anurti, Rori is the sutra. So Raha, Ri, what? Lopaha, Lopa Bhavati. Repasya, Repha Pare, Lopa Bhavati, that is the artha. Repasya, Rephe Pare, Lopaha. So when Repha is followed by Repha, then the earlier Repha will undergo Lopa. So the first one will undergo Lopa, first Repha. So what is the example there? Punar Ramate. So Punar is an avyaya, which means again, generally. So Ramate, again one rejoices. So Punar Ramate, the Repha, this Punar Repha, because it is followed by Repha, this Repha, Punar Repha will undergo Lopa. So you will get Punar Ramate. Now Punar Ramate is not really the form. What is the form? Because as soon as Rori in Tripadi applies, generally you cannot go back and apply any sutra when you are already in the Tripadi, and within the Tripadi also, within the Tripadi you should go in sequence. That is the general rule. But Vachana Samarthyat, there is a, because Panini Maharshi has used a sutra in some sixth chapter Pada, there that sutra will not have applicability in any other scenario because it applies only when repalopa has taken place, and repalopa is there only in the tripadi. Therefore, although general rule says that you should not go back from tripadi, within the tripadi also you should not go back in sutras in derivation process, definitely not across the chapters at all. So you should not go to sapada saptadhyayi from tripadi. But since this next sutra, which is what dhralope purvasya dirghonaha, this dhralopa, this dhakara and repa lopa, where is the dhakar lopa? Just prior to this rori lopaha, there is another sutra. So this is 8314. 8313 sutra is dhode lopaha. This is the lopa shabda which has anuruti in the next sutra, 14th sutra, rori. So dhakarasya dhakare pare lopa bhavati and repasya repa pare lopa bhavati. Both these sutras are in the third pada of the 8th chapter, therefore in tripadi. Now the next sutra is needed, and it has been mentioned. We have landed till punaramate, punaramate by repa lopa. But now dhralope purvasya dirghonaha is a sutra 6311. So dhakara and repa, dhra, when dhakara or repa lopa takes place, dhakara or repa lopa takes place, then it goes away. Then what happens? The purva an, an is a pratyahara, the purva an, a, e, u, that should take dirgha. This is in the 6311 sutra, sapara saptadhyayi. But this sutra will be wasted if it's an angakarya. It's an angakarya. Now, this sutra will go waste if the general rule of not going to sapara saptadhyayi from tripadi is followed. So therefore, see, all these rules which are found out, they are found out as per the sutras. So the sutra exists and it has to be applied because the nimitta for it is dhakara lopa or repa lopa, which is there only in tripadi. Therefore, for angakarya, these exceptions are allowed and you have to come back and apply this sutra. What will happen? This an will take dirgha. So puna ramate will become puna ramate. So this puna ramate, akara is an an, this akara is an an, therefore it will take dirgha and it will become akara. So puna ramate, those who do not know these sutras, what will happen? They will consider this as a typo or try to look for puna, what it means. They will not get the meaning in the dictionary. So it is punaha, punaha ramate will become puna ramate. Then similarly, what? Harihi ramyaha. Harihi is ramyaha, he is, you know, look at Hari, he is rejoicing. Or even ramya, it can be beautiful also, but ramyaha, sundara, or looking at, beauty is a meaning that you get from ramya, means one should rejoice in Hari, or one would rejoice in Hari. Why? Because of the beauty of Hari. So Hari hi ramyaha, what happened? Haris will become Hari, Hari ru, then this after rutva, ukara will go away and you will get harir ramya. Then repasya repa pare lopa bhavati, therefore hari ramya. Now this ikara by after rori dhralope purvasya dirghonaha will take dirgha, you will get hari ramya. Similarly shambhu rajate, shambhu shines forth. I'll skip this anahitikim. Yeah, for the next one we need this sutra. So manas, we need this example, sorry. So for next sutra, so manas rataha iti atra rutve krute hashicha iti utve rori iti lope. So these things have taken place. What has happened? Manas rataha, it's a samasa, manas rataha. So there iti atra rutve krute, so sakara will become repha. So rutve krute manasaha rataha manorataha, the chariot of the mind, literally. So manas, this sakara, after rutva you will get manaru, manaru or manar. And then what will happen is hashicha aplutat ataha ro ut, roho ut. So therefore, this ut is the replacement for ru. Ro ho ut. Ru will be replaced by ukara. Then there will be ad guna mano. You will get ad guna mano ratha. Or what? Mana ratha. This is the ex. This is an optional form as per what? Rory. Here, but this ukara here itself, not here, but mana u, either this will apply, meaning either this hashicha will apply, A, or what, B, because here one skip step has been skipped, this ru, ukara goes away and there will be repha. So this repha is followed by repha, ratha repha is following the mana ru repha. So there, this rori lopa is prapta. So if rori lopa is applied, then you will get mana ratha. So this will be the form with B. With A, you will get manoratha. Mana u ratha, and then ad guna, you will get manoratha. This is the expected optionality by rori lopaha. Not optionality, but these are two paths. Either you go to 6th chapter and apply hashicha, or since repha is followed by repha, you go to tripadi and apply rori. So these two sutras are applicable at the same time. They are both prapta at the same time, and they are different, have different karyas. They are at different sutras at different places, have different karyas. So now which should be applied? Should the 61114 be applied, or 8314 should be applied? 8314. Because both are applicable. Repha is followed by repha, therefore rori is prapta, and after sasojushuru rutva, the hashicha, because repha is following, so hayavarat onwards repha is included there, so repha is following, which is hash, and thereby apluta, the preceding not repha is following, this ru repha, not ratha repha, ru. This repha, this is a hash which is following akara, which mana, mana, the nakara and repha are sandwiched by akara. That akara is preceding, which is an apluta akara. So aplutat ataha roho utbhavati. So this repha is ru repha. So ru repha will take ukara adesha. Not any repha, but ru repha. So ru will take ukara adesha. This is prapta. So both are prapta. So what should be done? So the paribhashika sutra is read vipratishede parankaryam. So vipratishede parankaryam, and there is an, you can read an avagraha here as well, because avagraha may or may not be there. Even if the avagraha is there, meaning a is there, aparamkaryam. If a is there, then also you will chant as vipratishede param karyam by ing of padantadati. Therefore vipratishede param karyam is also possible as padachheda. Vipratishede aparam karyam is also possible. So what is applicable? So based on what is needed, the padachheda is done. Both padachhedas are valid, but general rule and utsarga, meaning utsarga and apavada to this split also, padachheda is followed, because what is said about vyakaranas who follow Panini rules, it is said that basically the meaning is that they are we do not form our army up front. What we do is that we look at the opponent's army, meaning whatever is needed at any particular time, and then we create the army formation. So I think akruta vyuhaha paniniyaha. So we don't make our army up front, meaning we will not say if someone asks vipratishede param karyam or aparam karyam. So there is some PhD research recently, last year it was in the news, that somebody, some Indian in US university or some university, he solved this. He didn't solve it. It is all, there was a big tall claim saying that, what across several centuries, what has not been, thousands of years, what has not been, resolved in Sampradaya has been resolved by a PhD student. It is not true. That person has not even studied in the sampradaya. So some possibility has shown which fails in all areas. Therefore, this paramkaryam, aparamkaryam, both splits are valid and they are explained in the sampradaya. So generally what happens is that you will take the when two sutras are applicable in one place at the same time, the one with the bigger number is taken. Bigger number means param. Param means later. What is later? Bigger number means what is a later sutra. Later sutra. Param means what follows later. So Tripadi, so generally what, if you look at bigger number, 61114 or 8314, which should apply there? So that is the later one should be karyam, should be the karya, sometimes aparam karyam. So that is the sutra, the tulya bala virode, param karyam syat. What is tulya bala virodha? Tulya bala virodha is when two sutras have tulya bala. Tulya bala especially means when they both have the same strength, and same strength also means that they are applicable not only at the same time, but when they are not applicable at the same time, they have different karyas, meaning they have independent applications also, independent areas of applications where there is no overlap, and sometimes there is an overlap. So in some words one sutra will apply, in some other words the other sutra will apply, but in case of a particular set of words there is an overlap, that is tulya bala virodha. And when there is tulya bala virodha, param karyam syat. So this is the tulya bala. So if you look at this, hashicha and rori have tulya bala virodha here. Where is hashicha applicable, where rori is not applicable? In this shivaha vanyaha. So shivaha vanyaha, there the hashicha sutra applies. Where rori is not prapta, because vakara is not repha. Now if you look at this punaramate, there rori applies. We already saw the example punaramate. There hashicha is not prapta at all. Hashicha does not apply there. So then what I said, there this they have tulya bala virodha. And where is it prapta? It is prapta ekatra in manar ratha. Here hashicha as well as rori is applicable. Rori lopaha iti lope prapte, says lagukara. This lopa is prapta. Why? Because vipratishede param karyam. That is the general rule. So you should apply the later sutra, which happens to be the rori sutra. Lopaha is prapta iti lope prapte through viprateshede param karyam, because rori 8314 occurs later than hashicha, which is 61114. Then he says purvatra asiddham iti rori iti asya asiddhatvat uttvameva. So what he says is that this is prapta, meaning you should be doing you should apply lopa of repha, the first repha. But what he says is purvatra asiddham, it is purvatra asiddham, therefore iti rori iti asya asiddhatvat uttvameva. So even if you apply rori, what will happen? You apply rori also, what will happen? Hashicha, the hashicha, from the standpoint of hashicha, rori does not exist at all. So rori does not exist at all. Thereby what will happen? Uttva eva. So thereby uttva will apply. Now this is one way to look at it. Some places it will be said that this vipratishede aparam karyam will also work, the earlier karya. So you do the earlier karya. So anyway, the form is that there will be no rori application, and there will be hashicha application, and then you will get uttva, then ad gunaha, and you will get the form manorathaha, manoratham. There is a paribhasha read here, puro para nitya antaranga apavadanam uttarottaram baliyaha. Uttarottaram baliyattvam. So what is the puro para nitya antaranga apavada? So apavada is stronger, uttarottaram bali. So apavada is stronger than antaranga, antaranga is stronger than nitya, nitya is stronger than puro para. So this is the relation which has been shown there. So here you look at these four types of comparisons are given. Puro para by vipratishede param karim. Puro or para, which should apply? So there between puro para you have to look at the param karim will apply or aparam karim will apply. Nitya anitya. Nitya means what? What is nitya? What is anitya? So krita krita prasangi yaha vidhihi sanitya. So what is applicable earlier also, later also, if you apply some other rule and still the first rule is applicable, so second rule you apply, still the first rule becomes applicable, so that is what nitya, it is a nitya vidhi. So here A and B both are applicable at the same time. If B is applicable even after applying A, then A becomes anitya A becomes non applicable, and once you apply B, then B is considered nitya. So this is the anitya anitya. So we should look at nitya anitya and puro para so far. Then there is antaranga bahiranga, which is antaranga, which is bahiranga. Then utsarga and apavada. These are the four kind of comparisons between sutras, which should apply between some rules. Now in that also there is a hierarchy. What should you look for? First you should look for, if the utsarga apavada applies, then you should follow that. They are uttarottara baliya. The latter is more effective, takes precedence. Meaning utsarga apavada kind of comparison will take priority over antaranga bahiranga, then nitya nitya, and then purvapara. Okay, so anyway, I would like to finish this and move on. We are spending a lot of time. Unfortunately, I usually don't do recaps. When I do, I prefer not to do with the book. If it is done with a book, then so many things occur there, and this book is particularly very verbose. So it is not only in Sanskrit, there are a lot of explanations given. So I get, I get lost there to, what to cover. And in the recap, if I go through this, then it is a repetition of, it's like an entire class. We have been doing very less recap. So I would like to speed this up and see only those steps which are necessary. Etat tadoho sulopo koran an samase hali. So what does it say is that in the etat and tat. So etat tadoho means in etat and tat, or rather sentences which have, or constructs which have sandhis where their etat and tat is involved. So there what happens, etatado sulopaha, the sulopa, the sulopa, sakara lopa will take place, the su, first case singular, sulopa will take place when followed by what, hal, halipare, when hal follows, then this sakara lopa will take place. When there is a particular reason, when it says that they should not be eshaka, saka, anesha or asaha. That is the akoho anan samase. Akoho anan samase. Only when it is not a nan samasa, and so nan samasa means what? Esha is not anesha and saha is not asaha. Masculine forms, look at those. Esha is masculine, saha is masculine. That person or that entity, and esha is this entity. And what akoho? Akoho means this ka pratyaya is there. Esha ka, then sa ka. Esha plus ka, then saha plus ka. Esha ka, sa ka. These are the forms. So when these forms are not there, then the first case singular pratyaya undergoes lopa followed by hal. That's all it is. So esha kaha, there visarga lopa cannot take. This is visarga sandhi, but this, what is that? Sulopa. So sakara at the end of the pada becomes visarga. Therefore, in eshakaha, sakaha, aneshaha, asaha, visarga lopa won't take place. Meaning, what is the final effect? But in eshaha and sahaha, the visarga lopa takes place. Hali, when hal follows. So the examples are what? Eshaha Vishnu becomes esha Vishnu. Then saha Shambhu becomes sa Shambhu. But eshakaha rudraha will not become eshaka rudra, it will become eshako rudraha. Then in anansam also, so asaha shivaha, not that shivaha, so asaha. देन हली इति किम एषः अत्र विल बिकम एशोत्र देयर विसर्ग लोप वोंट बी देयर मीनिंग सु लोप विल वोंट बी देयर सो दैट विसर्ग विल बी हर्ड इफ यू डू नॉट मेक अ संधि एंड इफ यू मेक अ संधि व्हाट विल हैपन द सु विल नॉट रीच द विसर्ग एट ऑल इट विल टेक उत्व इत्यादि एंड देन बिकम आई एंग पदांत अति यू विल गेट एशोत्र सोचि लोपे चेत पूद सॉरी सोचि लोपे चेत पादपूरणम सो पादपूरणम ओनली पादपूरणम चेत ओनली व्हेन द पाद इन अ पर्टिकुलर छंदस इन अ पर्टिकुलर मीटर लेट्स से अनुष्टुप छंद सम पर्टिकुलर वर्स इज चैंटेड इन अनुष्टुप छंद दैट श्लोक विल लूज इट्स पाद इन द छंद मीनिंग लेटर्स विल बी मोर इफ द Visarga is chanted, then the Visarga can be dropped. So what I said is that when followed by Hal anyway, Lopa is allowed, but followed by Ach the Lopa isn't there. There this Su Lopa should take place only when it completes the Pada in that particular Chandas. So that is the idea as to even when Ach follows, the Su Lopa is allowed for Etat and Tat, but then the Padapurana should be the result. In the case when otherwise it would be compromised, that time this Lopa is allowed. What is the example there? So this Jagati Chanda example is given from Rugveda. So Semam Aviddhi Prabhutim. So here, so there the wording, so Saha Imam, so Semam is there, Saha Imam, of course, I mean, what we will say when we don't know these rules, we will say it as a Chandasa Prayoga, Chandasa Prayoga. If we know the rules, then we will say, oh, by this rule, it has taken place. But generally what, this is also included with the rule also, what is not applicable elsewhere, there we will say Chandasa Prayoga. If it occurs in a smriti or arsha grantha, we'll say arsha prayoga. Iti visarga sandhihi. So visarga sandhi is over with this last sutra here, and thereby this first book is over. The visarga sandhi is over. Let's move on to the next book, which is close the wrong book. So let's go on to. So let's go on to this Ajanta Pullinga to Ajanta Napunsakalinga. So the next is Ajanta Pullinga Atha Ajanta Pullinga Prakaranam. Is it? Atha Shadlingeshu Ajanta Pullinga. So out of the six lingas, the Ajanta Pullinga is taken first. So vowel ending words are taken first. So Rama Shabda obviously comes first. Sanya Sutram. The first sutra is Artha Adhatura Pratyav Pratipadikam. So Artha Vat Adhatuhu Apratyaha Pratipadikam. Sanya Sutra. So what is Pratipadika? This is one sutra that gives Pratipadika Sanya. Other is Krittadita Samasascha. We have seen this earlier. Krittadita Samasascha. In this Sandhi Prakaran itself, we have seen the sutra. While deriving, basically when samasas are made, then we had seen it. So pratipadikam sanya is by two sutras. This is one of them. Arthavat, artha asya asthiti, arthavat, matu pratyanta shabda. So that which has meaning. What has meaning? Almost everything has meaning. Oh, that which has meaning, but it should not be a dhatu. Dhatu also has a meaning. So adhatu, that which is not a dhatu. Pratya has a meaning. No, it should not be a pratyaya. So that which has meaning, which is not a dhatu, which is not a pratyaya, that is called as pratipadikam. That is a pratipadika sanya. So here we can move faster because it's adhikaras or such sutras are there, and then derivation wise we can move faster here. Krittadita samasascha pratipadikam. This is the second sutra we have seen earlier in samasa formations while doing sandhis. So krut, tadita and samasa. What is the meaning? दिस कृत अंत तद्धित, कृतीचा प्रत्यय, तद्धितेचा प्रत्यय, सो कृत अंत अँड तद्धित अंत अँड समासाज आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू गेट दिस संज्ञा प्रातिपदिकम. सो कृत तद्धितांतौ समासाः च तथा स्युः, तथा स्युः मीन्स प्रातिपदिक संज्ञाः स्युः. सो दे गेट प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा. वॉट इज यूज ऑफ दैट? आफ्टर दिस प्रातिपदिक देर इज फॉर डेरिवेशन टू मेक अ पद यू कैन ऐड सुआदि प्रत्यय. सो स्वौ जस् अमौ क्षस् ताभ्यां भिस् नेभ्यां भ्यस् न्यसिभ्यां भ्यस् न्यसोस् आम् नियोस् सुप्. दिस इज दि 412 सूत्र. सो सेकेंड सूत्र. दि फर्स्ट सूत्र देर प्रायर टू दैट वॉज ज्ञाप प्रातिपदिकात् एंड देन प्रत्यय परश्चार कमिंग फ्रॉम दि थर्ड चैप्टर. थर्ड फोर 311 एंड 312 आर प्रत्यय एंड परश्च टू सूत्रज रिस्पेक्टिवली. सो ऑल दीज 21 प्रत्ययस आर ऑर्डेंड आफ्टर वॉट? नी आप प्रातिपदिकात्. आफ्टर अ नी आप और प्रातिपदिक मीन नी अंत आप अंत और अ प्रातिपदिक. प्रातिपदिक हैज ऑलरेडी बीन डिफाइंड इन दी अर्लियर टू सूत्रज गिवन बाय लघु. नाउ दिस नी आप इज वॉट? सो नी आप इज आफ्टर द स्त्री प्रत्ययस. सो प्रातिपदिक टेक्स अ स्त्री प्रत्यय टू बिकम एज दो स्त्रीलिंग प्रातिपदिक. सो प्रातिपदिक इज प्रातिपदिक बट टू मेक इट अ स्त्रीलिंग शब्द हाउ डू यू मेक इट? सो पर्टिक्युलर प्रत्यय एंडिंग वर्ड्स टेक पर्टिक्युलर काइंड ऑफ अदर प्रत्ययस टू मेक इट स्त्रीलिंग. सो स्त्री प्रत्ययस दे आर नी नीश एंड नी. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड बाय नी. सो नी दिस नी इज देयर इन ऑल थ्रीज. सो डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ प्रत्ययस विद डिफरेंट इथ लेटर्स आर एडेड टू बट द कंटेंट इज नी दैट इज कॉल्ड बाय नी. एंड वॉट इज आप? ताप डाप एंड चाप ऑल हैव दिस आप. सो आप अंत. सो आप अंत एंड नी अंत आर स्त्रीलिंग अंत प्रातिपदिक. स्त्रीलिंग प्रत्ययंत मीनिंग स्त्री प्रत्ययंत मीन इज स्त्रीलिंग एंड प्रातिपदिक दे गेट वॉट? सो विद दिस दिग्योगे पंचमी आफ्टर दैट प्रातिपदिक आफ्टर पंचमी ऑफ प्रातिपदिक प्रातिपदिक दिस पंचमी. सो आफ्टर प्रातिपदिक नी अंत और आव अंत दि सु औ जस् प्रत्ययस आर ऑर्डेंड. सो वॉट आर दिस प्रत्ययस? सो ही लघुकार से यू नो द सेट ऑफ थ्रीज प्रथमा द्वितीय इत्यादि अप टू सप्तमी. देन ज्ञा प्रातिपदिकात सूत्र इज कवर्ड हियर. दिस इज अधिकार सूत्र. लेट मी जस्ट क्रॉस चेक बिकॉज इन दिस बुक देर आर लॉट ऑफ सूत्र विच आर नॉट देयर इन लघु एट ऑल. सम आर स्किप्ड बाय लघु एंड देन एडेड हियर. सो हियर अजंत पुल्लिंग. इट्स ईजियर टू गो थ्रू दी बुक वेयर अर्थ. सो देर इज नो सच कृत्य समास ज्ञाप प्रातिपदिक. ओके सो इट इज देर. सो सूत्र. सो ई कवर्स एज टू वाई दिस इज नीडेड. ज्ञाप प्रातिपदिकात देन प्रत्यय परश्च. आई ऑलरेडी कवर्ड दैट इन दी अनुवृत्ति ऑफ दी सुओजस सूत्र. वॉट इज ज्ञाप प्रातिपदिक बट दैट सूत्र इज ऑल्सो कवर्ड इन लघु. देन प्रत्यय एंड परश्च ऑल्सो. प्रत्यय वॉट इज प्रत्यय? प्रत्यय मीन्स वॉट एवर इज इन दी फर्स्ट केस. दिस इज नॉट गिवन हियर. This goes till the end of the fifth chapter. So from 3.1.1 to end of the fifth chapter, the Pratyaya and also Parascha, both the sutras go till the end of the fifth chapter. So all these third chapter, fourth chapter and fifth chapter, all these, in all these three chapters, all the padas, all the sutras, whatever occurs in the first case is Pratyaya. Pratyaya is, the Lakshana of Pratyaya is not given. There is no definition given for Pratyaya. But what it means, Pratyaha, first case it is there. So whatever is in Samanadikaranyam with this, for example, Su is in Samanadikaranyam, Ting is in Samanadikaranyam, or Ni Pratyaha, Nich is in Samanadikaranyam. So all these are in all Krit Pratyahas, Taddhita Pratyahas, all those are in Samanadikaranyam Pratyaha. So Pratyaha, Nich Pratyaha Bhavati, Kutra Bhavati, where should it be applied? So you should say, न्याप प्रातिपदिकात और आफ्टर धातु. सो धातो हो आफ्टर दी धातु और आफ्टर दी प्रातिपदिका वॉट एवर इज एडेड ऑर्डेंड बाय विधि सूत्र इन फर्स्ट केस दैट इज अ प्रत्यय. सो दिस इज दी अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट दिस इटसेल्फ इज दी इज अ लक्षण. दिस प्रत्यय इज दी डेफिनेशन. इट्स एन अधिकार बट वॉट इज द डेफिनेशन वेन इट इज एडेड टू एनी ऑफ दी सूत्रज बिकॉज इट्स एन अधिकार सूत्र. सो अधिकार सूत्र प्लेस इटसेल्फ इन ऑल दिस थर्ड फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑल सूत्रज प्रत्यय वर्ड विल बी प्रेजेंट देर. एंड परश्च ऑल्सो. परश्च टेल्स यू वेर इट शुड बी एडेड. आफ्टर आफ्टर वॉट? दैट विल बी टोल्ड इन दी सेपरेट स्मॉलर अधिकारस धातोः आफ्टर धातु और न्याप प्रातिपदिका आफ्टर दी नियंत आवंत और प्रातिपदिका. सो देयर बाय यू गेट दिस प्रत्यय इज दैट विच इज इन दी फर्स्ट केस इन ऑल दीज चैप्टर्स एंड वेयर इट शुड बी एप्लीकेबल दैट इज सेड बाय परश्च एंड इट शुड बी आफ्टर आफ्टर वॉट धातोः न्याप प्रातिपदिका. देन what are the supratyas, what should you do with the supratyas, so when should you add what, all that is covered now as to sanya sutram. Supaha is the sutra. Then what is the anuvritti, trini trini ekashah ekavachana dvivachana bhuvachanani. So trini trini, all these 20 supaha, all these supaha is shashti ekavachana, so each of these get a sanya. Each of what? Each of the set of triads, trini trini, supaha trini trini. For the sup, the trini trini, there is vipsa. So each of these three, and there are 21, so we'll get 7 sets. Each of these 7 sets, ekashaha. Ekashaha, individually, ekavachana, dvivachana, bhuvachanani. They will get the ekavachana, dvivachana, and bhuvachana sanya. Each of these, or each of these threes, sets of threes, from prathama to saptami as counted in the laghu vritti earlier, each of these sets of three will ekasha individually, meaning 1 2 3 1 2 3, in each of these threes will get ekavachana dvivachana and bahuvachana sanya respectively. So you'll get what, prathama ekavachana dvivachana bahuvachana, then dvitiya amautshas are what, ekavachana dvivachana bahuvachana respectively. This is how you get the ekavachana and the sanyas. So anyway, need not be derived, none of these need to be derived, but then what he has done is that he is applying that Ram, Akar Anta Pullinga, Ram Shabda, he has taken that. So Ram Shabda, what will he do? How is Rama derived here? So here you say Rama Kridayam, so Ramu Kridayam plus Ghai, Ghai Pratyaya is added. So Halascha, Ghai Pumsi, Sanyam, Prayana, we have not seen these sutras, but this is added, and in it Rama plus Sa. All this is not needed from the dhatu, whether it is derived or not is not needed here. Ato upadhaya vriddhi ityadi. But this is the Rama Shabda, which is has a pratiparika sanya. Whether it is by krittadya samasascha or whether it is just a name, it may or may not be anuvartaka sanya. So it can be just a sanya. So Rama is a name of a person. Whether one rejoices looking at that person or not is not the meaning, not intended there. If it is intended, then maybe krittadya samasascha. If it is not intended, then just by arthavadhatu apratipadika, arthavadhatu apratyav pratipadikam, by that sutra you will get pratipadika sanya. We need pratipadika sanya, and then this Rama shabda can be derived by adding this suadi pratyas. So dvekayor dvivachane ekavachane. Now this is a Vidhi Sutra. Now this is a Vidhi Sutra. When you want to derive this, then what? Ekavachana and Dvivachana, what has been said, the sanyas are already prapta. Ekavachana, Dvivachana and Bahuvachana are the sanyas prapta. Now when you want to derive the Rama Shabda, what should you do? After the Rama Pratipadika, you should add a Pratyaya. Which Pratyaya should you add? Now you have got set of three, in which one is Ekavachana, other is Dvivachana, and the third is second is Dvivachana, third is Bahuvachana. Now when should you add Ekavachana and Dvivachana? That is given in one sutra as to Dvekayor, for two Ramas, Rama is an example taken. So for two Ramas you add Dvivachana Pratyaya, for one Rama you add Ekavachana Pratyaya, and thereby Dvitva Ekatvayo Etestaha, respectively Dvivachana or Ekavachana should be added. These pratyas are ordained. So Rama plus Su will be added, Ekavachana, because first you will say one Rama, then you will say two Ramas, then you will say three or more Ramas, Bahuvachana. So Rama plus Su will become Ramas, then Suptingantam Padam will give you Padasanya. For what? Ramas. Now this Ramas, Sakara will be replaced by Ru, Sasajesho Ru, so you will get Rutva, and then Ukara Lopa, Upadeshi Jannasika, Tasya Lopa, you will get Ramar. Earlier also, Su has become Sakara by Upadeshi Jannasikait, and this Tasya Lopa, Ukara goes away. So Ramas. Ramas, Ramaru, Ramar. Then what? This Ramar, what should happen? To apply this Kharavasayana or Visarjaniya, Avasana Sanya is needed. Why? Because Khara is not following, nothing is following this Repha. So Khara Avasana or Visarjaniya, for Repha to become Visarga, which is the form, what is needed? Avasana is needed because Khara is not following, this is not there. So Avasana is needed. What is Avasana? So that Akanksha is there here, is raised here. Rather, the Lagukara says this Sutra is called for by Akanksha of Avasana because that is needed. Ramara. There is Ramar, after that there is a pause. When you chant also Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, you don't make Sandhi between Ramaha and Ramo. There is no Sandhi made. Otherwise what will happen? Rori Lopa will take place and then after Dhalope Purvasya Dirgunaha, so you will have to chant as what? Rama, Ramo. That is not how we chant. Ramaha, Ramo. So there is a pause. That pause is called as Avasana. How do we know? The Sutra says Viramo Avasanam. So Viramaha Avasanam, the pause is called as Avasana. So all these, what is marked as this danda here, single danda, double danda, all that is really Avasana. There is no other, in fact, these are all markings, they are not there. You cannot pronounce a danda. Danda Shabda can be pronounced, but this danda is not pronounced. So this is all, you know, followed by a publisher, just like this Avagraha, just like this Avagraha, this is another symbol. Followed by publishers. There is nothing like that as to paragraph change, comma, semicolon, dash, none of that is there. It is just in a spoken language, everything is just a pause. And by intonation, you know whether it is a comma, either a full stop, and based on constructs. Otherwise, all these words are written together on the leaf. When it was written also, it was written on leaves. Therefore, there is no scope for giving space. So, my understanding is that based on the sandhi itself, we can know whether there is a comma or not. When sandhi is made, then you know that there is no comma. It has to be read together. If there is a comma, sandhi is dropped. So, for example, anuswara sandhi will not see. You should not see. Actually, when there is a pause, there should not be an anuswara. You cannot end up a sentence or pause at a sentence with anuswara. It has to be a makara. So, there you will see when in written also, when there is a makara and written together, then there is a comma there, you can pause there. So these are all hints given. We can understand or we can reverse engineer and understand by sutras. So varnanam abhava avasana sanyasyat. Varnanam abhava, there is a pause, meaning there is no sound uttered. That is what varnanam abhava means. Then rutto visarga ramaha. Rutto visarga, rutto will take place, visarga by kharavasana or visarjaniya, then ramaha shabda. Ramaha has been derived. Then what? Sarupanam ekashesha eka vibhaktau eva. So what does the Lagukara say here? He says, she's made a simple vritti here, but then what does the Lagukara say? Eka vibhaktau yani sarupani eva drishtani tesham eka eva shishyate. So only one remains. What is saying? Sarupanam ekashesha eka vibhaktau. So out of the four types of derivatives possible in Krutanta Shabda, then basically Dhatu derived Dhatu are what? Sanadyanta, Sanadyantaha, Krutantaha, Tadditanta, Samasas, and then Ekashesha. So Ekashesha is also a part of these five derivatives. Ekashesha is a derivative. So whether you say, you know, Mata Pitaro becomes Pitaro, the Dvivachana is maintained there. Mata and Pita will become Mata Pitarau when Samasa is made. And when in Ekashesha, what happens? Out of the two, only one remains. So the word Mata is not heard. It is dropped. But then the word Mata, the meaning of the word Mata is included in the Dvivachana in Pitarau. Pitarau itself can mean, in the school, if there are two children called, because they are fighting and they say, oh, you bring your parents tomorrow, and the mothers don't go, Chaitras and Maitras both are fighting, so Chaitras father all comes in and Maitras father also comes in for the, you know, PT, what a parent teacher meeting. Then there are two fathers there, so they are also Pitaro, but then Mata Pitaro can also become Pitaro, mother and father, the meaning is included. Similarly here, the other Ekashesha is what? When Balakaha, Balakau, Balakaha, there If the forms are same, meanings are different, forms are same, then you can say two balakas. So how do you say balakaha balaka balakascha balakascha balaka balakaha balakaha balakau? Then balakascha 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 balaka balaka balakaha. This is expected. Why? Because ramascha lakshmanascha rama lakshmanau, ramascha lakshmanascha bharatascha rama lakshmana bharataha. Then balakascha balakascha or ramascha ramascha is what? Rama ramau it should be. So there ekashesha rama ramau, rama and rama are different from what? There are two different Ramas. One is say Ayodhyapati Rama, Sitapati Rama, and the other one is say Balarama. And third one is Parashurama. So all three are called as Rama. So they are different entities, but they are called Ramas. Like Balaka. There are two Balakas, three Balakas, how many Balakas are there? So there you drop one. When the form is same, then you drop one. That is Ekashesha. Sarupanam Ekashesha Ekavibhaktau. So that is what the meaning is. So when they have the same form, you drop one and retain the vachana to include the other. That is the meaning there. So one remains and the others go. Ekashesha means one remains. Whether there is another or many others, that is irrelevant as long as they have the same form. So Ramaha is derived. Now Rama plus Au, because this is what? Dvayakor, Dvekayor, Dvivachana, Ekavachane. So Dvivachana is intended here. So when Dvitva is there, then Dvivachana Pratyaya is added, which is Au. So this is Prathama Dvivachana, you add Prathama first and then Sarupanamekshe Ekavibhaktau. There what will happen? Only one will be there. Rama Rama plus Prathama Vibhakti. Rama Rama plus Au will become this Au. Rama plus Au. Then you will get Rama plus Au will become what now? It is said there is some Sandhi Prapta. What is the Sandhi Prapta? So Pratamayoho Purvas Savarnaha Aka Dirgaha Achi Puro Parve Ekaha Samhitayam. This is all Anuruti. So Pratamayoho Purvas Savarnaha Pratamayoho. So Pratamayoho, there is a dual. Pratamayoho means out of the seven. So two out of seven. That is the meaning of Prathamayo. Out of the seven Vibhaktis, Prathamayoho for the two, first two. First two Vibhaktis, Purva Savarnaha. Purva Savarna meaning what? The Purva. Purva Savarna Dirgha. Purva Savarna Dirgha is the Adesha for what? For Akaha Achi. So, Ach should be following and for this Ak. Not for this Ak, but Ak. Basically what if you say for this Ak, for both of these, both are Sthani. Panchami, this Panchami Ekavachana and this Saptami Ekavachana. Dirgha is the Adesha. Puro Parayoho Dvayoho. Ekaha Samhitayam. When the Samhita Sandhi takes place, then one single Dirgha Adesha is there for both Ak and Ach, because Ak is followed by Ach and Ach is preceded by Ak. Therefore for Ak and Ach, both together are replaced by, basically Purva Savarna Dirgha is what? Dirgha, this means Dirgha of Ak, the Ak which is preceding, so which is Purva. So Purva Ak, Purva is Ak, so Purva Savarna Ak, Savarna Ak, whatever is the Ak letter there, Savarna Dirgha will take place and it will replace both Ak and Ach, Purva and Para. That is the Adesha Sutra, Vidhi Sutra. But then that is Prapta now. So that Dirgha is Prapta, meaning what? Here you have Rama plus Au. So by, if you apply Prathamayo Purva Savarna, this is Prapta. So Rama A, Dirgha is A. So Rama A and Pratya Au both would be replaced by A and you will get Rama, which is not the case. So what will happen? Rama should not be the form. So there is next sutra which is read there. Nadichi. Nadichi. So Prathamayo Purva Savarna Dirgha Purva Parayoho Eka Samhitayam. Samhitayam Vishaye Purva Parayoho Prathamayoho in the two Vibhaktis Saptami Dvivachana. In the two Vibhaktis, what will happen? Purva Savarna Dirgha for Purva and Para. This is Prapta. Akara and Au, Rama A and Au both should be replaced by A as its Purva Savarna Dirgha. But here Nadichi, when ich pratyahara letter follows, ich H will include au also. So H here is what? Au. Au is following and of prathama and dvitiya vibhakti. Then what has happened? That is ich. So ichi, ichi pare na. Kim na? Purva savarna dirgha na bhavati. Therefore, there is no dirgha. This is negated. The avarna rama a avarna. And what is that? Aath. Aath means when the avarna is preceding, meaning the ak which was preceding, that ak is an avarna. Then this purva savarna dirgha will not take place if the following letter is a ich letter. Thereby, it is negated. So now there won't be a savarna dirgha. So what happens here? Rama plus au, it will become what? Now since ad ichi after an a the puro parayor ekaha adesha won't take place. What is that? Savarna dirgha. Then what will happen? Vriddhir echi, it will revert back to whatever was prapta earlier. See, Vriddhirechi 6188, this Vriddhirechi was negated by Prathamayoho Purva Savarnaha, Akasavarne Dirgha. So, Vriddhi was replaced by Akasavarne, with the Akasavarne Dirgha, but Purva Savarna Dirgha there. And here what is happening? Nadichi is negating that. So, Vriddhi which was Prapta, which has gone away by Prathamayoho Purva Savarna, is negated by Nadichi. That Prathama Purva Savarna is negated by Nadichi, and then Vriddhi which was Prapta will apply. So there you will get Vriddhi Rechi. So Vriddhi is the Adesha for both Akara and Aukara, and then what will happen? Rama plus Au will become Ramo. So we got Prathama Dvivachana and Dvitiya Dvivachana also. Then this Bahuvachana, this is Dvekayoho Dvivachane Ekavachane was read. Now, for Bahuvachana, what do you do? Bahushu Bahuvachanam. So, Bahuvachana is a sanya which was given, and in Vidhi Sutra, it says that when many are there, then that time you apply this Bahuvachana Pratyaya, which happens to be what? Jas Pratyaya. Thereby, Jas Pratyaya is applied here, and you get what? This Rama plus Jas. Now, he reads a Sanya Sutra, which is basically what? The Sutra which will give the It Sanya for the Jakara of Jas Pratyaya. Chutu Pratyasyadehe Upadeshe It. And in an Upadesha, the first the first letter of the Pratyaya is It. Which first letter? The Chutu, the Chavarga and Tavarga letter. So here Jakara happens to be Chavarga letter, therefore it is It, and then thereby Tasya Lopaha will apply and Jakara goes away. So you have the content is Us. But Sakara, which is Prapta as It, the It Sanya is Prapta for Sakara being the last Hal by Halantyam, that has to be negated, otherwise Sakara will go away and you will be left with A. So there Lagukara introduces Vibhaktischa Sanya. Vibhakti Sanya is there. That sutra already been? Yeah. So now Vibhakti is coming up. So she gives a Sanya Vibhaktischa, because Na Vibhaktau Tusma has to be introduced for Sakara to be protected, which will otherwise go away by Halantyam. So Sanya, It Sanya is Prapta by Halantyam, but not in a Vibhakti. That is the next sutra. This is the third sutra, 133. 134 says Na Vibhaktau Tusma. But what is this Vibhakti? Vibhakti Sanya is not known. Therefore, he introduces Sanya Sutra here, Vibhaktischa Ting Sup. So, Ting and Sup both are called as Vibhakti. Generally, we hear Vibhakti in what? In Ting only. In Sup only. But in Ting also it is there. In Sup, we say Prathama Vibhakti, Dvitiya Vibhakti, Ityadi. But in Ting, what do we say? Prathama Purusha, Madhya Purusha and Uttama Purusha. But Vibhakti is also applicable there. Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, Vibhakti, it can also be said as Vibhakti there. So Vibhaktischa, Vibhakti Sanya is given to Sup and Ting. Then this generally, there is a paribhasha read here as to what this the Ting and Sup are said. So in Sanya Sutra, the Pratyas, when the Pratyas are given a Sanya, then this they won't take the Tadantavidhi. So the not the Tadantavidhi, but the Paribhasha won't apply. Pratyagrahane tadantasya grahanam was a paribhasha. Now that sanya vidho pratyagrahane tadanta grahanam nasti is another paribhasha. That says that when pratyaya is being given a sanya, that time that anta, it should not be taken, thing has been said, then it should not be taken as thing anta there. Or sup as subanta, but it just means thing and supratyaya get the vibhakti sanya. Then the navibhaktau tusmaha, tavarga, sakara and makara, which are the upadeshe it hal antyam, at the antya hal, last consonant in an upadesha, they wouldn't get this, na it, they'll not get the it sanya when in a vibhakti they are tavarga letter, sakara or makara. Thereby the sakara of jas is protected, so you will have rama plus us, just will become Rama plus us, and then this will not go away. There will be what? Prathamayo Purva Savarna Akaha Purva Parayo Dirgha is not mentioned here. Dirgha. So Dirgha is missed here. So there is a Dirgha missing here, Shabda. So Purva Parayo Ho Dirgha. And then you will get what? Rama will become Rama, and then this Akara and Rama. It will be both will be replaced by Rama. Akara and you get Ramas. This Ramas is Suptingantam Padam. It is a Subanta Pada. And then Sasojisho Ru will give Rutva. Then Ukara goes away. Anubandha Lopa. Then you will get Ramar. Then Kharavasanayur Visarjana Ramaha. Ramaha is the Prathama Bahuvachana form. So Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha. Ekavachanam Sambuddhi. So He Rama, He Ramo, He Ramaha. Ekavachana Pratyaya, where prathamayaha sambodhane, when the sambodhana in the sense of sambodhana, visheshaptami, prathamayaha, this for this prathama vibhakti, which ekavachanam, that ekavachana prathama vibhakti in sambodhana gets the sanya sambuddhihi. Feminine word sambuddhi is the paribhashika sabda. Sambuddhi is a sanya, basically it's a sanya. Sanya sutra gives sambuddhi as the name for prathama ekavachana in sambodhana. It is the same ekavachana pratyaya, prathama ekavachana pratyaya, prathama vibhakti pratyaya, but it will get, but soon will get in sambodhana, soon is applied, but it will get the sanya as sambuddhi. Then the next sutra, yasmat pratyaya vidis tadadi pratyangam, anga sanya is introduced. So this is a complicated sutra to read, but it is very simple in understanding. So yasmat pratyay vidihi, this pratyay vidhi means something is ordained. What is ordained? Pratyay. Pratyay vidhi means pratyay is ordained. By whichever sutra, whatever pratyay is ordained, it is ordained after something. So what is it ordained? Sup pratyay is ordained after a pratipadika. Ting pratyay is ordained after a dhatu. So yasmat dhato ho or yasmat nyap pratipadikat. That is the meaning of yasmat. So after whichever entity, call that as let's say we'll call that as A. Why A? I'll explain later. Let me just call it as unknown X. So X is after which a pratyaya is ordained. Let's say P1 pratyaya is ordained after this X. So when it is ordered, this X can be a dhatu also, pratipadika also. So P1 is ordained for X. Now let's say P2 is ordained for X plus P1. P2, just assume this, and so you get an idea, two are sufficient right now. So anga, what is the anga for P1, what is the anga for P2? This is the question, because anga is to be defined now. So when anga is defined, anga is the definition. So what is anga? Tadadi is anga, tadadi, and yat and tad are in samanarthika, yad, yasmat, so x adi, the beginning of x, so which is this point. This point here, this is the tadadi. So this, what does it say? Yasmat pratyavidihi, after which any pratyavidhi is given, pratyaya is given as a vidhi, is ordained, tadadi, adi of that, for which the pratyaya was ordained, beginning with that, tadadi pratyaye, pratyaye pare, up till the pratyaya. So this P1 is ordained for X, P2 is also ordained for X. So beginning with this for P1 and for P2 also beginning with this. So for P1 what is the anga? Beginning with this pratyaye. till the pratyaya. Till which pratyaya? When P1 is ordained, till the pratyaya P1. So before the beginning of P1. So that is what? X. Pratyaya pare. So end of X. So this is the anga for P1. This is anga 1. For P2, which is the anga, it will definitely begin here because P2 was also ordained for X. So it was ordained for X. It will begin from here. But how long will it go? It will go till pratyaya P2 pare. So till the P2 does not begin. So this entity will become A2. So what it means that P for P1, the anga is beginning with X and ending with before P1, ending before P1. And for P2, anga starts with X but ends before P2, meaning it also includes P1. So for A1 is what? X. Value of A1 is X. Y for whereas value of A2 is what? X plus P1. Why such complicated definition? Because he wants to give a generic definition, not applicable only for dhatu or pratipadika or for samasa, because there are samasanta pratyaya, there will be anga for tadhita pratyaya, so or anything. When it is ordered, it is a generic definition. Now, why tadadi has been given? Because tat is a pronoun which will include dhatu, pratipadika, anything, tadjita, anything, you know, pada also for a tadjita, for example, or a samasa. Now, what this eventually will mean is that the upasargas which are added, let's say there are two upasargas also, U1, U2, upasargas, they are not included in the anga. In the anga definition, these upasargas are not included. That is the meaning. So with that basis, let's complete this sutra and move on. Eng hraswat sambuddhe he. So now when he Rama is said, then Rama plus su, in which meaning this su is sambuddhi, sambuddhi, prathama ekvachana, but sambodhana pratyaya, sambuddhi. So sakara of sambuddhi, hraswat after an eng or hraswa. After an ing letter or a hraswa letter, the sakara of sambuddhi, when it follows sambuddhehe, of the sambuddhi, what happens? Hal lopaha. So sakara is an hal letter, hal lopa. Hal lopa means basically it is what? Hal lupyate. It means lopa means lupyate, because hal and lopa cannot be in samanadhikaran. So hal is, you can say halaha lopa by saying hal is in prathama, but it is lupta shashti. Thereby you can say halaha lopa, or you can say hal lupyate. So lopa can be converted to tinganta and say hal lupyate. So sakara will go away. Hal, sakara is hal that goes away. So sakarasya lopa you can say, or sakaraha lupyate. So sakara goes away when this in sambodhana. Therefore he Rama, this sakara will go away. Ukara goes away by upadeshi janyasika tasya lopa. Then Rama plus sakara, Ramas, will become he Rama. Sakara will go away, you will get he Rama. So that is he Rama. The other two are same, meaning prathama dvivachana and prathama bahuvachana are the same pratyas for sambodhana also. So the forms are same, Ramo Ramaha, he Ramo he Ramaha. So here so the ami purvaha, ami purva is a sutra. Already overshot time, I didn't look at it. So we'll look at the dvivachana in the next part. I'll stop here. Ami purva is the sutra for Ramaha, Rama plus Am. So Rama plus Am will derive in the next part. Tavasane Nataraja Rajo Nana Dhatakkana Panchavaram Uddhartu Kama Sanaka Disiddhan Ekta Vimarshe Shiva Sutra Jalam. Namaste Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.
Namaste Dhanyavada.